Good morning and thank you for joining me today. I'm José Cisneros, the Treasurer of the City and County of San Francisco and co-chair of the Cities for Financial Empowerment Coalition. And I want to acknowledge the number of people joining me here, including former Supervisor Bevan Duffy. The mounting evidence about San Francisco's hometown bank is shocking. It reveals that Wells Fargo used personal information about their clients to open accounts without consent and in some cases transferred funds into those accounts. As treasurer, I'm responsible for keeping the city's money safe. And 10 years ago, I started the Bank on San Francisco program because I believe that everyone's money is safest in a bank, not held in cash and hidden under a mattress. When I learned that low-income people in our city didn't have basic access to financial institutions, I worked with banks and credit unions to create safe, low-cost accounts without barriers to access. Now, thousands of San Franciscans each year open their first bank accounts through the Bank on San Francisco program, and there are Bank on programs in dozens of cities across the country. And just last year, we announced national Bank on standards for safe bank accounts with no overdraft fees. So after hearing about the actions of Wells Fargo, I met with an executive of the bank to find out what information and advice I could provide to San Francisco consumers. He couldn't give me even basic information, including how many San Franciscans were affected. Have they been notified? How much restitution will they receive? This is simply unacceptable. I'm outraged on behalf of all customers, but also for every unbanked resident that will continue to keep their money in cash instead of in a financial institution. Given their widespread, egregious, and potentially criminal actions, I am suspending Wells Fargo from the Bank on San Francisco program effective immediately. And we can't wait for Wells Fargo to help people through this terrible experience. That's why I've asked Balance, the city's consumer credit counseling partner, to offer free one-on-one credit counseling for anyone affected. Starting today, San Francisco residents can call 1-800-706-6006 and speak to a qualified credit counselor to run their credit report, to find out if they've been affected and what to do next. I want to thank Balance for stepping up. Their phone number will be on our website, sftreasurer.org. Let me be clear. This is a free service, and no one's going to try and sell you anything. That's why Balance is the city's partner in our smart money coaching effort, and I give you my word that they can be trusted with your financial information. Next week, I'm headed to Washington, D.C. to meet with representatives in the Cities for Financial Empowerment Coalition, at the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau, and with members of the California Congressional Delegation. And I'm calling on all my colleagues across the country to stand with Bank on San Francisco. We have been the nation's leader in financial empowerment, and we will continue to stand up against financial institutions that breach our trust. There are many unanswered questions, but I want San Franciscans to know that the city will help you get answers from Wells Fargo to resolve any negative impacts these actions may have had on your finances. Now next, I'd like to invite Andrea Lucetta Kern from the California Reinvestment Coalition to join me at the podium. Andrea?
Thank you so much, Treasurer. There are too many families in the San Francisco Bay Area and across California total who, without a safe and affordable bank account, spend hundreds of dollars cashing checks, buying money orders, paying bills, running all over town when last-minute emergencies happen and they need to conduct a financial transaction. The San Francisco Office of Financial Empowerment, through the Treasurer's Office, and nonprofits in the Bay Area and across California have worked so hard to make bank accounts more accessible to all families, including low-income families, including Spanish-speaking families, and other new immigrants who are not familiar with the banking system or who have been historically left out of the banking system. And we have made tremendous progress. As the treasurer mentioned last year, the National Bank On Coalition adopted standards to really make those accounts truly safe so that folks could feel confident that they would never face an overdraft fee, that they could have a low monthly fee that even could be waived with a small amount of direct deposit. These are the accounts that people need, that work for them, and that meet their best interests. Wells Fargo's actions are undermining our work. Now is the perfect time for them to not only express sorrow and say that this is never going to happen again, but to really step up and do the service that they need to do in the best interest of the clients and help them to repair any credit damage they have experienced. This should not be something that we have to do. They should be doing it. But we are thankful for Treasurer Cisneros' leadership in providing this service because too many people don't know that they've been affected. So now is the time to call Balance and find out, how has this affected you? Have you paid fees? Has a new credit card been opened in your name without your knowledge? How has that impacted your credit report? Were you offered a higher interest rate on a credit card that you did want because this damaged your credit report? We also at CRC are calling on all of the banks, local government, the bank regulators to work with us to restore trust in the work that we're doing. To really, for the banks to step up and say, Wells Fargo does not represent us, they don't speak for us, we don't do what they do, we don't look at our customers as potential sources of fee revenue that we're trying to cross-sell just to pad our bottom lines and our executive bonuses. There are so many banks and credit unions who are doing very good work, offering these truly safe accounts, working hard to meet the needs of low-income families across the Bay Area. And we celebrate them and we applaud them and we encourage them to step up and speak out and reassure all of their customers that what Wells did won't ever happen to them. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Andrea. I'd also like to introduce Sean Klein, the head of our San Francisco Office of Financial Empowerment. I'd also like to introduce Lee Phillips, the president of our great partner EARN here in San Francisco. And at this time, I'd like to introduce Catherine Davis, the president and CEO of Balance, who explained to us how their staff are ready to assist folks. Catherine?
Good morning. Thank you so much for being here. You know, there's obviously been a lot of news and media on this incident. And the biggest thing that concerns us is there's been no information for consumers. And I'd like to applaud the city of San Francisco for stepping forward in recognizing that consumers who have been impacted, they might not know what to do. And there are consumers that likely don't know they've been impacted. So we've set up a dedicated toll-free number where consumers can phone. We will help them get access to their free credit report. Despite this being available, consumers today still don't know how to access that report, let alone know that they can get a free credit report. One of the free services we offer is a credit report review. We will walk through that with a consumer to help them understand what is on that report, if they've been impacted, how they clean that up. One of the things that greatly concerns us about this situation is it's just not the credit products that have been opened at Wells Fargo, but if a consumer on their own opened products with other institutions, did they receive higher rates? Has their credit been negatively impacted? And so we really want to make sure that we're able to work with our consumers to resolve that. We, of course, will provide assistance and resources in terms of, you know, how they contact Wells Fargo. We know that consumers do not review their bank statements. Folks are more apt to look at balances, and so we really want to remind and encourage folks to review bank statements, whether you get them online or in paper. And so that's another piece that we'll be educating and providing support on. And then just in closing, just to really echo that this is so unfortunate that we still have so many folks that are unbanked, and I think those that have placed their trust and faith in financial institutions here, we really believe that's a big piece of our job to make sure that they stay banked, that they understand the process, and that they have that confidence in the safety of working with a financial institution. So thank you so much. I applaud the city of San Francisco, the treasurer, and my fellow nonprofits who do this work every single day. Thank you.
Thank you, Catherine, and I will repeat the 800 number right now. The 800 number is 1-800-706-6006. We're handing out some flyers that have that information on it, and that number will also be on our sftreasurer.org website. The firm is called Balance. I can't say enough about the great work they do and how vital it is that they'll be available to help people that are going through this difficult time dealing with anything that may have happened to their Wells Fargo accounts. I'm excited also to introduce my colleague, Supervisor David Campos, to join us now. David?
Thank you. Good morning, buenos dias. I want to thank our treasurer for what he's doing. And you know, the thing about what Wells Fargo has done is that the damage really goes beyond the impact on anyone who has been impacted by these accounts, these fake accounts. It's on the issue of trust, because we have been working with a community that has been very distrustful of banking institutions for a lot of different reasons, immigration status, whatnot. And so we've had to do a lot of work to let people know it's okay, that you're better off coming forward and actually putting your money into these banking institutions. And now we have to kind of redo that work and sort of say, you know what, we weren't completely right about Wells Fargo. So let me say it in Spanish. Creo que el daño que ha hecho el banco Wells Fargo va de más del impacto en las cuentas individuales y los individuos. Tiene que ver con la confianza que una comunidad tiene con estas instituciones bancarias. Porque estamos hablando de una comunidad, especialmente la comunidad inmigrante, que no tiene mucha confianza en estos bancos, tal vez miedo por su estatus de inmigración. Y hemos tratado de convencerlos de que es mejor para ellos que metan su dinero en un banco. Y luego cuando un banco como Wells Fargo hace lo que acaba de hacer, creo que eso daña mucho esa confianza. Entonces tenemos que hacer aún más trabajo. So it is very unfortunate, but I'm very proud of what our treasurer is doing, and it makes sense that San Francisco would lead the way on this. I'm very proud to be associated with it, and I just want to say thank you to you and your office for that. Quisiera otra vez agradecerle al tesorero de la ciudad, José Cisneros, por el trabajo que están haciendo. Muchas gracias.
Thank you very much, Supervisor. It's great to have your partnership out here in this effort today, because we're trying to let everybody in the city know there's things they can do to keep their money safe. So once again, the bottom line, I want to make sure everybody knows the city is here to help, and particularly our good friends at Balance are available every day starting now to help people make sure their money is safe. Let me repeat the number again, 1-800-706-6006. Please share that information with everybody in your community, everybody in your family. Make sure we all have a safe account, a safe place to keep our money, and we're all successful financially. Thank you very much for your time today. Thank you for coming.